With that, let me turn it over to Jonathan Greenblatt. You go first.
Great. Thank you very much, Governor, for your inspiring words and for your leadership this morning. This comprehensive agenda that you've outlined today is a significant step forward in ensuring the safety and security of the Jewish community here in New York. And as you said, it is a model for other states around the country. By any measure, 2019 was a devastating year for the Jewish community in New York. At the ADL, we tracked more than 300 anti-Semitic incidents, including acts of harassment, vandalism, and violence, which really culminated in the horrible attacks that we saw in this whole area, but in particular in Muncie, New York. In short, you know, the world is grappling right now with the coronavirus, but we indeed have a pandemic of prejudice right here in the Empire State, and this virus of anti-Semitism that's affecting all of us. And that's why we're so grateful for your leadership and your commitment to try to inoculate our community from this. The proposal you've outlined today, with a pledge of $45 million in funding to provide security and peace of mind to the Jewish community and to our nonprofit organizations, it's one of the most substantial plans we've seen from any elected official at any level in this country. But it's only the beginning. To fight the scourge of hate, we need more corporate and community leaders to stand up. We need more people from faith-based institutions to speak out. We need to ensure that our schools are teaching our children not to hate, to ensure that our local police have the appropriate resources and training to both investigate and prosecute hate crimes. And we need to make sure that social media companies are taking effective measures to fight the rampant spread of hate speech on their own platforms. That's why ADL launched a center in Silicon Valley in 2017, because Facebook is the front line today in fighting hate. And at ADL, we know that no community is safe unless they are all safe. So this proposal to require New York schools to include a curriculum on civic values, on diversity, on religious freedom, we are very eager to see that implemented, because we've seen the bias of anti-bias education. It indeed is a way we can inoculate our children from the disease of intolerance. ADL's comprehensive Holocaust education program, Echoes and Reflections, has had a real impact in New York State since it was conceived in 2005. To date, we've partnered with school districts and museums and teacher centers to deliver over 150 professional development programs, reaching more than 4,000 educators across 824 schools in New York State. And Governor, we are prepared to work with you and to work with the museum any way that we can to support your new mandate. Our No Place for Hate program, I'll just point out, continues to reach thousands of students across the city and state as well. In fact, we recently announced a doubling of the number of students we're reaching in Brooklyn, targeting 40 public schools in an effort to educate those young people who are so often perpetrating these crimes against the Jewish community. We want to reach them before it happens. You know, Governor, when the tragic attack in Muncie occurred, you were on the ground immediately. You deployed the state police across New York to protect our synagogues and schools, and you marched with myself, many of the leaders here, and tens and thousands of New Yorkers. It was a remarkable moment, again, the kind of leadership we haven't seen from other governors, you know, elected officials across the country. And I think perhaps most importantly, you have spoken to this core issue that anti-Semitism is anti-American. And it's not just a Jewish problem, it's everyone's problem. And your authenticity on this and your genuine on this, I think it touches all of us, and I believe it resonates across the country. So we're grateful to that, because as you said, we are all New Yorkers, and we're proud to stand here together and to sit with you today, and we'll do everything that we can to turn this legislation into a reality.
Thank you.
Thank you
so much. Thank you so much.